Because anytime you start picking and choosing who you're going to sponsor, you're saying, God, I don't trust you. Does that make any sense to you? You're saying yes?
Yes.
Okay. All right, so now we know that there is, that the Big Book gives us the basis for sponsorship as a one-on-one adventure through the steps and through spiritual growth. And absent this, we're not going to stay sober. You see, we have to deal with a lot of paradoxes in this program. A paradox is something which is absolutely true but does not appear to be. It appears to be opposite to what we have come to believe or have been taught as being true. We must be willing to give away what we have been given in order to keep it. Now, if we want to look now at what has happened, why are we all here? How did this fellowship come about? It all started with what we just read. Bill's being inspired to believe that he must take this message which he'd received, these principles, and take them out to other alcoholics. And he did just that. And for the first 6 months of his sobriety, nobody got sober. He was very discouraged. He didn't know how to carry the message. Now, one of the things that we're going to be looking at two or three different times is exactly how to work with a newcomer. This is not a question of something which comes out of publications. It's not something that we pick up from psychiatrists or counselors or down at our local parish hall. How to work with newcomer is set out in specificity in chapter 7. Now, when Bill first got started, he didn't know how to do this. You see, he had to learn, and then he passed on to us what he had learned and what the others in the early groups learned, because this was a matter of trial and error at first. His first efforts at getting somebody sober would be very crude, like going up to a guy in a bar and saying, you look like a drunk to me, you want to get sober? And we go, oh yeah, I guess so. He'd say, get on your knees and start praying, sucker, you know. And that didn't work very well. In fact, it didn't work at all. And then he would take them into his home, and they would get drunk in his home, or they would steal something, or burn his mattress, or whatever. For 6 months, he didn't get anybody sober. Finally, he went to Dr. Silkworth in desperation, and he said, Doc, I don't know what's going on here, but nobody's getting sober. Dr. Silkworth gave him the first instructions he had ever had on how to go about doing this. What Dr. Silkworth told him at that time is now incorporated in chapter 7 in these specific instructions about working with somebody new. Among other things, it's critical that we establish a degree of confidence in us. We have to set it up so that the new person can identify with us, feel that we're bona fide, that we know what we're talking about, and we learn how to do that, because they've been kicked around from pillar to post. They've been moralized with, they've been shouted at, they've been embarrassed, they've been psychoanalyzed, they've been shot full of dope, all kinds of stuff has happened to them, and they never stayed sober. And here we are, we're coming along saying, I know how to get sober, I did it myself. So who are you? One of the things that we have to start off with is the fact that the new person needs to know that we know what we're talking about, so we establish our bona fides with them. And Dr. Silkworth also made it very clear to Bill that one of the things we have to do with somebody who's new is to make sure they understand what the problem is, that they're sick, that they have an illness, and we have to describe this illness to them. This, of course, means we better know what that is. We better know that doctor's opinion cold. Because when we're doing this, what we're looking for is a reaction from them where they'll be able to say, gee, this person really knows what they're talking about. I better listen to him. I better listen to her.